Bienvenuti a Benevento on the final day of competition in the women's football at the Napoli Universiade 2019. John Soyon comes across to take it. Played into the far post. Good hands on that there from Moeka Yonezawa. Good, honest punching. Kim Hwang-na sends it in, and it's glanced home by Wee Johnson. The first time any DPRK attacker had been given freedom inside the Japanese box, and the punishment has been administered. Wee Jong-sim for DPRK scores the opening goal in the gold medal match. Very patient build-up here from the team in red. Well, that's almost the last resort for them at a cross elevated from the wide areas. But when they did deliver it, it was a super ball in, and we there left all alone to head home. Wee Jong-sim, slung over by John So-yeon. Mako Kudo with the header. Picked up by John So-yeon again. Kim Hwang-na. Can't wait to see the possession stats here at the end of the first half. Kim Nam-hui now, the captain. Kim Ok-yeon, oh, the little drop of the shoulder, the feint, and away she goes. Ri in support, plenty of bodies in there again for DPRK. Moeka Yonezawa punches it away. Kim Hwang-na now. Thanks, two defenders with her. And, well, it won't be the corner that she wanted, but still a throw in a good situation off Reni Wakotsu. Well, Yonezawa might not have been able to gather that, but she at least punched it clear of the immediate danger zone. We're going to see changes, no question, in the second half here. But it's very difficult to identify the threat and then stop it with DPRK, who lead in this gold medal match at Napoli 2019. They're on course for a third Universiade triumph in women's football. And we scored her third goal of the competition. It's the goal that separates the sides. It came in the 28th minute, and the Democratic People's Republic of Korea are in a good situation here against Japan. They lead by a goal to nil. Ri Hyang-sim, dispossessed, but that just underplay touch in the middle of the park there from Romina Chiba. Manami Yoshida committed the foul and then races back to get in position. Got plenty on the ball there. Kim Na-hui there with the pass. Helped on by Ri Hae-yeon. Back for the goal scorer, Wee. Assured play at the back again from Kim Nam-hui. A very capable defender, the captain of the DPRK team. That's a foul though, committed by Pak Sin-jong. Little glance touch there from Chiba. Shot is deflected onto the crossbar. Unlucky from Sara Amada. The follow-up, though, is drilled home. It's 1-1. Yurina Imai following in to power home. A captain's goal there for Japan. She read it really well because the ball cannoned up and on the top of the bar. Initially, it was unlucky, the shot from Sara Imada just takes a nick off Paxin Jong. Oh, this is the angle, isn't it? Imai keeps the shot low and threads it through. But the world will descend once again on Japan next summer for the Tokyo Olympic Games. Indeed, it's what, a year and a week and a half away, that, the Tokyo Olympics. Remember some of the names here, because if the DPRK squad can keep together and be competitive in the qualifiers, we might well be seeing them challenge for medals next year. Rian Chong. Chiba should get the flick on as well. Drills the pass into Sara Imada. Yurina Imai now. And more speed, less haste really for Japan. 19, Hong Kumhyang. On for Wee. Work the best opening. Rhee hits it! What a goal! What a goal in the dying moments of the gold medal match. That's the way to win a final. If indeed they could hang on to the end. Kim Kwang-min keeping his thoughts very much to himself. That is an absolute beamer. And look at the clock. Oh, what a finish. It beats Moeka Yonezawa, all ends up. John So-yeon, what a finish for one so young. Well, all the sessions, the training ground routines in terms of keeping possession, not letting the opposition have the ball from the DPRK. And they come into ever the more important perspectives now as Japan comes searching for an equalising goal in stoppages at the end. Romina Chiba couldn't connect. Rian Chong plays it forward. Well, it's the rueful smile of the Japanese coach. There'll be an element of feeling philosophical about it. If you're going to lose, it might as well be to a goal of just real high quality. Tsuneda with the throw, one final push. This has to be put into the box, but blanket defence from the red shirts. Played over the top by Sekiguchi. And they will run down the clock now. The seconds tick down. Democratic People's Republic of Korea are the golden girls in the women's football at Napoli 2019. A spectacular winning strike, which came 2 minutes from time from John So-yeon, has meant that Japan lose another final, their fifth Universiade final. They just can't get over the line. So the DPR of Korea win the gold for the third time after 2003 and 2007. You can add 2019 here in Naples. We score the opener. Imai for Japan hit back 12 minutes into the second half, but 2 minutes from time, John Soyeon let fly, and DPRK are celebrating the gold medal. A brilliant golden goal to win it, 2 minutes from time for the triple. A third gold in the women's football, and in never more spectacular fashion has the gold medal been won. So DPRK succeed the Brazilians. Japan lose the final for the second Universiade in a row and for the fifth time overall. But what a goal to win it. Four worthy champions. Democratic People's Republic of Korea have beaten Japan by 2-1 here to win the gold medal in the women's football at the 2019 Universiade.